Okay, I want to look at updating the compiler into C++. The one with Orwell is getting a little outdated. For instance, if we do initialization with the braces, like we see in this example, we may have some problems compiling. So let's go up to the menu and compile this. And we should at least get a few errors telling us, hey, that brace initialization didn't become available until C++ 11 standard. Well, okay, so we could add that probably in this 4.9 compiler. So maybe a better example would have been if we put in a single quote here to kind of denote 2000. This is allowed in, I think, C++ 14 and beyond. But it's not going to work with this. So let's try to compile that. And sure enough, it's like, you got a quote in there that's not working. So let's see how we update the compiler so at least the compiler won't give us those errors. So the compiler we're using, we can go to this website. And I'm just going to go to the download area. And we'll download, actually it will be a downloader. Okay, so the setup program here. So I'm gonna go ahead and download that. And it will take a second or two. And we'll go ahead and say save that. And we'll open that folder and go ahead and run that program. Okay. And so we'll install this, and it'll take just a second or two to install this, and we're actually installing the installer, okay? And so that takes a second or two, and then so we'll hit continue, and it actually ran. So this is actually the install manager. So we can close this just to show you that it's a program installed on the computer, so I can run it again, double click on it, it opens up. And so we actually want to install the compiler. So I'm going to run through here and find the GCC compiler. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to get the BIN, which is the binary of it. So we'll just click there and mark that for installation. And then we'll also need the make file. So let's scroll down and we'll find make. And again, the binary part of that. So we'll mark that for installation. And then we'll see if we can find... let's see, GCC, should be G++ in here someplace. And we'll mark that one for installation. And once we have everything marked, I'll go to installation and go ahead and apply changes. And we'll apply that. It'll download the components it needs and install those locally. I'll go ahead and skip ahead to completion. Okay, so we jumped ahead after downloading the parts, it will install them. Then we can close this dialog and go ahead and close this window. We'll go back to GDevC++ and we'll go into compiler options. And we'll go to this window and go ahead and say this third choice here, add a compiler by folder. And we'll go down to the C drive, and the default installation goes to the root of C. So I'll click on that and click OK. And click OK there, and that should add it to our drop down list. So we can actually select that as a compiler. And we'll try to compile it and see if that works. And it looks like it did, so let's execute. And so we get the area of the rectangle. So without any compiler errors, we can use that compiler and use some of the more modern standards in C++ without getting those errors. We still will have a problem with def C++. Notice the apostrophe notation here. It's still using an old standard, so it's expecting a closed single quote there that it's not going to find, right? So, but at least we can compile modern C++ programs without a problem. We'll look at a couple of these things in future videos. So until then, happy computing.